Thank you.
All right. So these are the last boxes from the car. Finally. What's all this?
What? I can imagine my uncle had this many friends.
Oh, come on. Just because he's dead or declared dead doesn't mean he was this wonderful man.
It's so dusty in here. You know, I'm actually surprised this place didn't collapse during the war.
Oh, and thanks again for helping with this, by the way. You know, I haven't spoken about this in a very long time, but seeing as we are up here rooting through all his crap, I may as well tell you some stuff about him. What? How does that still work?
Oh, pass it here. I bet you 100 pesetas that this is my mother.
Hola? Hola, mama. We're just starting now. Because we only just got here? Yeah, I know, I'm counting down the days. Well, I'll only be back in time for the fitting if you let us get on with it. No, I'm not shouting. I'm not shouting, this is just my voice. Hola? Mama? You know, me and my mom don't exactly see eye to eye, right? And now she's appointed herself as the wedding planner and... Oh, it's just too much.
I wish I could be as excited as her, but I don't know, I'm just not.
Sometimes I wish I could just run away from it all. Just escape to some paradise. Feel the sun on my skin, the salt in my hair. You know, cut my teeth on some proper adventures. Well, it's not the most practical plan, is it?
Come on then, these boxes aren't gonna pack themselves. Would you mind looking in those drawers while I rummage through this cupboard?
No, I'm not shouting. I'm not shouting, this is just my voice. Hola? Mama? You know, me and my mom don't exactly see eye to eye, right? And now, she's appointed herself as the wedding planner and... Oh, it's just too much.
I wish I could be as excited as her, but... I don't know, I'm just not.
Sometimes, I wish I could just run away from it all. Just escape to some paradise. Feel the sun on my skin, the salt in my hair. You know, cut my teeth on some proper adventures. Well, it's not the most practical plan, is it?
Come on then, these boxes aren't gonna pack themselves. Would you mind looking in those drawers while I rummage through this cupboard?
Oh, it's jammed. Just give it a good tug. Oh yeah, sorry. I was telling you about my uncle. Firstly, don't be fooled by the cheesy bow tie. This man had some real skeletons in his closet. I must have been 9 or 10 years old when I got sent here. I was a bit of a troublemaker growing up, and my parents thought I could use some old-fashioned Catholic discipline. Though when I got here, discipline was the last thing on my mind. Okay, so picture this. It's 1935, a beautiful summer in Madrid. I've just arrived off the train, and guess who's there to greet me?
She was the cutest little ball of squiggly fun I've ever seen. Her name was Paquita. I didn't even know my uncle had a dog. And we fell in love instantly. Oh, and at the time, I fancied myself as quite the little Sherlock Holmes. I mean, I probably read too many stories, but I couldn't wait to get out there and investigate my first real case. But Manolo, my uncle, really didn't have the same plan as me. He just wanted to sit around inside, twitching his mustache and rustling those stupid newspapers. This was going to be my summer? The worst part was, whenever he actually did anything, he would never tell me where he was going, never invite me, and he locked the door behind him. And I mean double bolted. So soon enough, my exciting adventure had turned into a bad case of cabin fever. I remember wondering if I could genuinely die of boredom. Eventually, things got so bad that I just started doing the housework, just for something to do. Of course, that didn't last very long. So, with nothing else to do, I started investigating anything I could get my hands on. Paquita is my wily sidekick, of course. But even Dad rattled my uncle's cage. And soon enough, he... Well, he had enough. And, in a bid to get rid of me, he gave me something. I had no clue what it was, but it didn't take me long to figure out that it was an old camera. As soon as I got the hang of it, that was it. I knew I had found my calling. I love taking photos of things, even just around the house, especially Paquita. Oh, she did quite a few knocks in the process, but I think she loved the attention. And for a while, I began to forget that I was trapped in here. My uncle never joined in any of the fun, of course, or even noticed what we were up to. Now that I think about it, it must have been around that time that I started to realize that Manolo was barely home at all. It wasn't just during the day either. He was always... As soon as I put my head down, there he was, shuffling across that same squeaky floorboard every night. Did he really think I wouldn't notice? Come on, I knew he was up to something. Something shifty. Something worth investigating. And so this went on, night after night after night. I just couldn't take the mystery any longer. I rooted through this whole damn office looking for some sort of, I don't know, some sort of clue, but there was nothing. So instead, I started to document his movement. What time did he leave? What direction did he go? Which tram did he take? And I started snapping photos of him every time he crept away.
But even with all that evidence, I just couldn't piece it together. To be honest, I was about to give up until this one day. This one day when he came in with this bag. And right away, you could just tell there was something odd about it. Now, I don't know what I expected to be in there, but I'll tell you now, it wasn't that. I've never seen so much money before in my life. Where the hell did he got it from? And why? That was it. That was the moment I knew Manolo Monreal was not the man I thought he was. So at the very next chance I got, I followed him. This whole time I've been waiting for a case. But it was great. I was on their tail, getting closer and closer to the truth, when suddenly I lost them. Out there alone, I could only think about one thing. The gun. I really hoped it was just for self-protection, but I couldn't have been more wrong. Thank you. I was freaked out. I tried to keep up, but what could I do? I lost them again. And then, strangely, fluttering about in the wind was his bow tie. I was the only one left on his tail. And inside, I could see nothing but stairs leading down into darkness. So in I went, and the darkness welcomed me. And that was it. There was no going back from there. As soon as I got home, I told my mother what had happened, and she just brushed it off. Didn't even give it a second thought. I mean, I saw her brother, her own brother, kill somebody. Actually, murder someone. After a while, I stopped telling because, well, nobody ever believed it. I mean, why would they, really? It just sounded so silly. That's my mom again. She's the last person I want to talk to right now. Hola? Yep, still here. Because we're packing up his whole damn life. I'm not wasting time. I said I'm not wasting time. Oh, por el amor de Dios. Look, I gotta go. Okay? Bye. Wait a second. Right, what have we got here? Take this out.
What's wrong with you?
No, I'm okay. I'm not hurt.
That's strange. Where did the bullet go?
Wow, a police badge? I wonder what poor devil he stole that from. It says these are blanks. That's why they look so weird. Blanks. No, I saw him shoot that man. He fell off. The light.
Because if there is...
We've got to be careful.
All right. Here. Beg them on the line to dry. Nothing? Nothing yet? Oh my god, this is nerve-wracking. What's in that photo? What?
Dearest Lola, I hope that you will return someday and this letter will find its way into your hands. You deserve my full honesty. Honesty. I don't think I know what that word means anymore. You must believe me when I say that those men you saw me with are not and never have been my friends. No. These are animals, brutes, who have been trying to take control of this beautiful city for years. My job was to infiltrate this group, become one of them, and bring them down from within. But as cruel fate would have it, they accepted me into their rotten world the same day you, dear Lola, arrived on the train. What's worse, in my distraction, I'd gotten sloppy. Perhaps it's my age or maybe the liquor, but it's no excuse. Carelessness just won't cut it when you're undercover. Soon enough, one rat has sniffed out another. I've been close to coming undone before, so I've learned a thing or two along the way. I knew I had to offer him something, something no one else would. Have you ever wondered how police protection sounds to a rat? Like an opportunity. He didn't need much, just a gentle push, and about as much sauce as my old liver could take. And soon enough we were in business. The guy liked to talk, and I was all ears. I am not ashamed to admit it. The guy grew on me. We had the kind of friendship that only men who know each other's secrets can have. It seemed I was safe, and so for a time were you. But soon enough, the wolf started to smell a rat in the lair, and I started to sweat. Suddenly, I was handed a gun and promoted to pest control. Now, I hate rodents as much as the next man. But I'm no killer. So I did exactly as the wolf asked. I got rid of the problem, my way. If there is one quality that defines rats, it's their survival instinct. He wasn't gonna turn down a one-way ticket to some distant South American paradise. It needed no small amount of finesse. I had to collect on a few debts and cash in some favors, but after some theatrics, the rat was on his merry way to freedom. The only thing I'd overlooked? An inquisitive little girl and a cross-eyed hog. We were damn lucky to escape that place. The wolf was on the hunt and I had no intention of letting any of us become his prey. But I couldn't do anything until I knew for sure that you'd be safe. So, I had to send you home, Lola. God knows you'd already seen enough misery in Madrid. every truck in my life ran through that station that night. You were gone. The rat had his bounty. And the wolf. The wolf had followed my trail. There's a reason why they hunt in packs, Lola. Alone, their bloodthirst tends to get the better of them. His prey had become his predator, and my own pack was closing in. But I couldn't hang my head up quite yet. You see, there's two parts to putting criminals behind bars. The first is what you see in the movies. You knock him out and lock him up tight in the darkest corner you can find. But if you don't have yourself a proper case, sooner or later they'll find a way out. I hope you know I couldn't have closed this case without you. When all is said and done, I know nothing I say will excuse or make you forget how I treated you. But if I ask anything of you, it's to hold tight to the good things, the in-between times, those little moments of joy that we so readily forget. If only I could turn back the hands of time. I would have quit this game a long time ago. This is no life for an old dog like me. My place was making memories with my only niece. And now war is on its way. So I too must leave. I sure will miss this city. A smarter man than me once said that the best lead you'll ever get is your own gut. Don't let anybody drown that voice out, Lola. If only I'd listened to mine sooner. I leave you with my endearing love, your uncle, Manolo.
Don't look at me like that. You would be crying too if it was your uncle. All this time I thought, it doesn't matter what I thought. I was wrong and now he's gone. Forever. I just wish he would have told me sooner. Who knows what happened to him? He could have disappeared during the war or gotten polio or, I don't know, run away with a lover or something. Wait, that is the only thing I really know, right? That he's gone. Let me see. It's been, what, 15 years or so? Okay, well, he was old, but not that old. Look at this. San Francisco, Saigon, Casablanca, Rio, Paris, and there's this date. Okay. This might sound insane, but if Manolo was crazy enough to hide a letter and a photo in an old camera for me to find it, it's not that hard to believe he will be sending this here, right? And look at this one. November the 5th, 1950. That's less than 6 months ago. Hola? Mama? Of course it's me, Mom. Listen, Mama,
please listen to me this time. I'm not getting married next month. Oh, I don't know, maybe next year? I'm sure he'll understand. And if he doesn't, so be it. No, Mama, that's not the point. I just have to follow my gut on this one. Yes, I'm absolutely sure. I love you too. Adios.